stood out to me when I got out in 1998. I've been out since 98. And that was the point that 84% of the male children of an incarcerated male will also be incarcerated. 84% of the male children of an incarcerated male will also be incarcerated. I got 3 boys. So where they supposed to be? They're supposed to be locked up. Now, you know, they play with numbers, right? They can play with statistics. They do that. Now, my daddy had 3 boys. It was myself, my brother, y'all know the one I told y'all I used to deal with down, and I had my baby brother who was 7 years younger than me. My dad went to prison 3 times. How many times did I go to prison? 2. My brother under me went to prison. 2. My baby brother, my mama got him in a headlock, took him overseas, and said, not this one, I ain't gonna lose this one. And she did, she smothered him. And he's doing his thing. He didn't go to prison, but he did go to jail. He didn't go to jail. And I looked at that, and I looked out from behind that razor wire, and I saw it wasn't any positive male role models. Not an immediate family for my kids. And it was up to me to make a difference and do what I had to do. And I had to tell him. One of the things I told him always was to live your dream. Live your dream, son. I want y'all to live your dream. But they needed an example of that. They needed an example. And I did what I had to do. And now today I keep my recovery first. I've been home now 13 years. March 30th made 13 years that I've been home. September 30th made 14 years that I've been clean and sober. You know, because when I don't add alcohol, I don't get an asshole out of it. But I turn into an ass when you add alcohol, I know me. I'm going to fight. I'm going to smoke crack. I'm going to cut a damn fool just to be straight up with you. And I'm going to go to jail. And it ain't promised. That last time when I had those assault cases, they weren't police officers. I was trying to commit suicide by cop because I knew I was facing 15 to life. I knew I was facing 15 to life, and I didn't have it in me to do it again. God saw fit not to let the officer shoot. He didn't shoot. And while I was in the drunk tank, that last time, I was in the drunk tank for 3 days, the devil was sitting right beside me. And I said, you need to kill yourself. You're a piece of, you ain't nothing. You need to die. And I never forget that. I was totally crazy. I'd been up for a week, drinking, smoking weed, any kind of pill I could get my hand on, smoking crack for a week long, trying to make sure I died. But I came out of that trying to figure out, how am I going to kill myself? I got to die. I got to leave it. I can't call my kids. And somebody walked up to me and he said, I don't even know who this guy was. He said, man, as long as you got breath in your body, you got another chance. And for some reason, that one thing snapped me out of it. And I said, okay, I ain't doing nothing with my life, God, what you want me to do with it? Can you do something with me?